okay, I want to coach a lesson plan, and this is a lesson plan based on O SOTO GARI and teaching how to use O SOTO GARI more effectively. So we just do a routine. This routine involves a line step. So we'll step back, the partner steps back for you, you come in for O SOTO, and you try and apply pressure. Just a straightforward in the line pressure with your forearm here, your hand on their neck, and tight, so you like a shimmy here, keep your elbow in, and push down and bring their weight across, arc their weight across the shoulders, and they resist it. So you resist like hell, Sam. Yep. And then you've got to apply more pressure. So you keep your body in a straight line, it's safe. You don't strain anything. And then I'll lean into it. If I can throw them, I almost will, but I'm not. You've got to be careful that you don't dig your heel into the knee, because you don't want to collapse their knee on like that. It's not that. It's calf on calf and through here and applying pressure with the back of your heart muscle here on over and your back of your knee. But you don't go like this, heel in the knee, it's dangerous. You go back, you do it back. So you're resisting by dropping your hips and pushing through and down, learning to keep your power in the line. Okay. The next one is going slightly around the corner. So you do that on me. Yep. Yep. So from here, I'm still resisting. Then they hop around the corner.
And then throw.
Yeah. And then throw. They would throw.
But you can do it on me.
Yeah. But it's kind of like teaching the next part of the sequence. This is the next part of the sequence. It takes a whole lesson just to do that first bit. That's a lesson just to do that last bit there, to get people to keep their body strong. But when you've got that, then you go, I'll do about this angle here. Here, then you hop around the corner, just small hops, and then you would do the throw. And you throw them in their weight direction. Because every time you come in for a sort of gary, I guarantee the other person's going to put their leg back. You put your leg back fast. Like that anyway. So you've got to drop, you've got to lean in, and hop around the corner to throw. That's the second lesson. And the third lesson, the third part of the lesson, or the third lesson, is when teaching this person the counter to it, here. So as you come in and you do that technique on me, here, and you go to hop around the corner, then I need to step back and do a quarter turn, and then lift my leg, do O SOTO GARI kaeshi. So I step back 90 degrees. That means my foot is facing this way now. It's gonna face this way. So I gotta lock in on the stand here. I'm gonna lift my wrist under their chin if I can, like that. Just use your wrist under their chin late in the technique. But I step back quarter turn, I lean forward and lift leg. Do O SOTO GARI kaeshi. One more time, and maybe I'll have side to the side. He hops around the corner, but I step back, lean forward. So that technique is if I'm facing this way, I've got the leg back here. My job is to step back quarter turn to here, like that. Here, lean forward, lift leg. So you go, step back, quarter turn, lean forward, lift leg. That's O SOTO GARI kaeshi. And children really need that for O SOTO GARI, otherwise they do O SOTO GARI all the time, and it stops them, takes them out of that habit. The next part is, the next lesson is setting the O SOTO with a Sasae. So we go, Sasae, O SOTO, yeah, Sasae and O SOTO GARI, and we're linking the two throws. So sometimes you might go O SOTO GARI, Sasae, and other times you might go Sasae and O SOTO, and then you also add a koso. So we've got Sasae, O SOTO, koso. Yeah, it's kind of like the good to learn this bit here. I mean, hip it here for the pretend and step with Sasae. When they step for the Sasae, they hip this bit here, you pretend. You need to move your hips, the belt moves across to show you have hip power. That's a demonstration of hip power. You're hipping and pretending to to attack here, but instead you just put your foot down, stiff, and use the body turn power. Use the body turn power as lifting under their elbow here, like that. Here. So, lifting under here and drawing out using the wheel here, out there, trapping the foot for the Sasae tsurikomi ashi. When you put it the other way, it's more normal. You go the other way, you go Sasae and O SOTO and hop around the corner. And there, it's almost like five lessons. By the time you get through that, that's a good week of tuition, you know, with a little bit added each day with the same kids, you know, or each week in a row, you can add to that lesson and build up the technique. But you spend a bit of time on each one, and it's well worth it because people get a better understanding. Okay, thank you.